Now we will learn how to fix mistakes using the Reconciliation Discrepancy Report. This report will show any change to the cleared balance. This means any transaction that has already been reconciled, any transaction that has been marked cleared in a previous reconciliation, that has been changed after you reconciled, will show up in the Reconciliation Discrepancy Report. How do you know when there has been a change to the cleared balance? You don't even know if you should look at the discrepancy report if you don't know that there's been a change to the cleared balance. Well, the beginning balance of the window of reconciliation will not match the beginning balance of the bank statement. Now, that's a problem. You cannot continue with bank reconciliation until you fix the beginning balance. If you don't fix the beginning balance, nothing you do during the bank reconciliation will make the numbers match if the beginning balance is wrong. Let's take a look at what the cleared balance is right now before we make any changes. From the main menu, click Banking, Reconcile. The first window that opens up shows us what the beginning balance should be. This file says it was last reconciled on February 28 of 2015. That was our previous video. The video that came before this one reconciled the bank account on this date. And the ending balance, which matched the cleared balance, was $46,205.04. To fully understand this, let's actually change something that causes the cleared balance to be different. Let's unclear one of the cleared checks and see what happens. Let's imagine check number 24, dated February 16th, will be uncleared even though it was already cleared during the bank reconciliation process. The register window is where you can clear and unclear transactions. From the main menu, click Banking, Use Register, then click OK. Your register window will open up and make sure that you have one line format checked off. This way it's easier to find the transactions. Right away I notice transaction number 24, or excuse me, check number 24, dated February 16th, is right here for $685. Between the payment column and the deposit column, there's a thin column with check marks. This column indicates whether an item has been cleared during the bank reconciliation process or not. If it does not have a check mark, it means it's an outstanding check or a deposit in transit. We did not place the check marks in this column. QuickBooks automatically placed the check marks in this column during the reconciliation process. When we come down to the check that we want to unclear, it's very simple. Click right on the check mark that indicates that it's cleared. Removing it will unclear it and tell QuickBooks this item has not cleared the bank. When I click on it, I get a warning message that we are screwing up and messing up our previous reconciliation. We already know that we're messing up our previous reconciliation for example purposes, so just click yes. Notice if you only click once, you get a star. You have to click again to remove the star and have the field be completely empty to be able to completely unclear this check. The star will be explained in the next video after this one. But again, click twice to remove the check mark and record the new status. When we click record, we get another message that says, excuse me, Last month was reconciled perfectly, and now you're messing it up. We already know we're messing it up for educational purposes, so just click yes. Now when we go back to the field that shows the cleared balance, we click banking, reconcile, aha! The beginning balance has changed. A moment ago, it was $46,205. Now it's $46,890.04. That's because we uncleared a check and the cleared balance changed. This is not the proper beginning balance, and if you look at the bank statement at the beginning of March, it will not match this number. If you ask what is the reason why the number doesn't match, the answer will almost always be on the Reconciliation Discrepancy Report. From the main menu, click Reports, Banking, Reconciliation Discrepancy. Okay, make sure that you click OK, that you're choosing the correct bank account. Now, here's the discrepancy report. The only item is the check that we just uncleared. It was the check on February 16th, and it actually shows you the date and time that the transaction was modified. So I am filming this video on August 9th at 3:55 p.m., and that's why it says 14:54:23. The thing that I changed was the cleared status. So this report will show exactly what happened and explain why the beginning balance is now wrong. Now let's change it back before we get into trouble. Banking, use register, click OK. We can easily find check number 24. Just click right here in the margin to put back the check mark. Click record to update the new cleared status and click yes. Now let's see if everything's okay. Banking, reconcile, aha! The balance has come back to $46,205. In fact, if we open the banking reconciliation discrepancy report now, for the correct account, cash and bank, we notice there are now no discrepancies on this report. Now let's delete a cleared check and see what happens. Let's delete check number 21 dated February 10 to UPS for $98.98. So from the main menu, click banking, use register, click OK, and we said that this would be the check for $98.98, I believe it was February 10th, check number 21 for $98.98. Click here in the line of the check, right-click on the transaction, and then choose Delete Check. Are you sure? Click OK. Now when we take a look at the beginning balance, we click Banking, Reconcile, aha! We notice the beginning balance here in the reconciliation window has changed. The cleared balance has changed, and this beginning balance, which is our cleared balance, now will not match the beginning balance of the March statement until we fix the situation. If a person wants to see what really happened, he or she can click Reports, Banking, Reconciliation Discrepancy, click OK to make sure you're looking at the proper bank account. Now look, it says check number 21, which was dated February 10th. It says it over here, the type of change deleted. And it was deleted on August 9th at 3:02 or 3:01 p.m. And this will stay on the Reconciliation Discrepancy Report until it's fixed. So how do you fix the beginning balance for a cleared check that was deleted? Well, the first thing you need to do is re-enter the check. That's probably because you should not have deleted that check in the first place. Only re-entering the check is not going to fix the problem. You then have to clear the check in the register window. Remember, if you re-enter a check with the same money amount and check number, even the same payee, QuickBooks cannot assume it was the check that was deleted, and QuickBooks will not automatically clear it. You would have to clear it yourself. Let's take a look. From the main menu, click Banking, Use Register, then click OK. The bottom of the register is where we re-enter all the transactions. The date is February 10. The check number is check number 21. The payee is UPS. Delivery expense comes up automatically. And then the money amount is $98.98. Push tab to save the field. Click record. Notice as soon as you record the check, it jumps all the way up here. That's because right now my register is sorted in date order. So I recorded the check long after the other checks, and it jumped up into its proper position in date order as soon as I saved it. The problem is not fixed. Just re-entering the check will not fix the cleared balance. You have to actually clear the check that you just re-entered. Click in the margin, in the right margin in this little field. Of course, you're going to get a warning message that you're messing up the previous reconciliation. QuickBooks does not know that this is the same check that we deleted that we are now replacing. But we know it, so click Yes and leave the check mark there. You have to click Record again to record the new cleared status. Now, there are three very important things that you must know after you fix a deleted check that was previously cleared. After you re-enter it and after you record it as cleared, unfortunately, the discrepancy report will still show the problem until after the next bank reconciliation. So, even though you saw that we fixed it, when you reopen your reconciliation discrepancy report, unfortunately, this check will still show up as deleted. And this will be here until we do the next month's bank reconciliation. Another unfortunate problem regarding this issue is that after you fix the problem, the cleared balance will still be wrong in the first reconciliation window. Now, don't worry. When you go to the second reconciliation window, the cleared balance will be correct, and only there you will be able to see that the problem is solved. Let me show you what I mean. When we click Banking, Reconcile, unfortunately you can see that the beginning balance is still wrong. Even though we re-entered the deleted check, and even though we cleared the deleted check. However, let's just enter the number 0 into the ending balance field for a moment. The only reason I'm doing that is so that QuickBooks can have something in this field to allow us to go to the second window. When we click Continue, the second reconciliation window opens up, and you can see down here that the cleared balance is now correct, $46,205, and you can see up here the UPS check has been replaced and recorded as cleared. So again, don't be intimidated by the fact that the deleted check that you re-entered and also cleared is still showing on this report. Don't be concerned about the fact that it's still showing up in the first reconciliation window. As long as you put 0 in the ending balance, it will allow you to continue to the second window, and the second window will confirm that you're starting with the proper cleared balance.